Welcome to this presentation on factoring out a common binomial factor. Sometimes the greatest common factor of a term is a binomial. And this greatest common factor, it's called your binomial factor. And you can factor this binomial factor out just like you could a monomial factor. So in other words, you can take it out like you can any other number. So let's look at some examples. So here, our greatest common factor is a binomial. It happens to be x minus 3, which is what's in yellow. And here it's x minus 3. So what we do with these is you take 7 minus 2x times x minus 3, and that's it. You take your numbers in front of your parentheses and you rewrite them so that they're in a set of parentheses, then you're going to multiply them by what's already in parentheses, x minus 3. Now this only works if these binomials are the same. Like here, you got a minus here and a plus here. We can't factor anything out. Nothing we can do. Can't do nothing. Can't do anything. So remember that. You'll see some problems like this on the test. Don't get them wrong. So I got this one here. What's in yellow once again? That's your common binomial, but here there's nothing in front of this parenthesis. So if you don't see anything, well, you know that's an understood one, right? So you got negative x plus 1. We're going to wrap those around in parentheses, and we're done with that. And what's left is what's in our parentheses, which is x squared plus 4. And that's it. That's it. Another example. Here, so our common binomials, x squared minus w. And sometimes it helps to circle what you're going to put in your first set of parentheses. So you got 9x minus y times x squared minus w. So even if there's a bunch of numbers, don't let those numbers confuse you. And I'll just treat them like they're regular old numbers. And this is really important because as we're looking at things like this, x minus 3 plus, I don't know, 4x times x minus 3. This is important because when you do factor by grouping, you've got to be able to see that these binomials are common factors. And people struggle in math because they're not used to binomials or expressions or equations, whatever. You know, they're not used to treating them like they would a common factor, because you know people have no problems saying, hey, the GCF here is 4, right? That's no problem. But when we start throwing in parentheses and numbers, to get a little confused, that'll you know they act like it's harder than what it really is. But just remember, if you're in my class, I've said this a few times, anything and a set of parentheses can be treated like a number. And it can be treated like a number because it is a number, you know. Last little tidbit here, and we'll call this one quits. So you got now 9 times x plus 4 plus x squared times x plus 4. Each of these terms, it's a term, right? That's a term, right? Term. These are all terms, right? So each term, it's its own individual number. We don't know what these numbers are, and we don't need to know what they are. You know, that's why we have variables. We use variables for stuff that we don't know. So last one here, you got 9 minus x squared. Took what's out in front, right? Then we're going to multiply it by x plus 4. So the most important thing with this is being able to see that when you have binomials that have the same numbers inside those parentheses, you can treat them like it's its own number. And you can pull out that greatest common factor. If you can do that, a lot of what we're going to do in algebra and algebra 2 is going to be easy for you. So that is factoring out a common binomial. Ask questions.